This lesson is a little different to the other lessons in this course, because there's no hands-on work. The lesson consists entirely of theory. The lessons that follow will give you all of the skills you need to apply themes to your own worksheets. But for this lesson, I recommend that you simply sit back and listen to it, and don't try to follow through with any of the features demonstrated. You'll be doing that in subsequent lessons. So let's move on now to exactly what a theme is. Themes are a hugely misunderstood concept in Office, and it will be much easier to follow through with the subsequent lessons if you know where you're going and understand exactly what themes are all about. So, what exactly is a theme? Well, a theme is simply a set of fonts, colours, and effects that go very nicely together. A font set consists of two complementary fonts that work well as a pair. A golden rule of typesetting is to never have more than two fonts in a document. Old school typesetters would always use a serif font for the body text, also called normal text, and a sans-serif font for the titles. You can see that serifs are those little embellishments on the edges of each letter. Here's an excerpt from the printed book that this video course is based upon, and you can see that we've followed convention in the book by using a sans-serif font for the titles and a serifed font for the body text. But there's a modern school of thought that suggests that breaking this rule is cool, and Microsoft have done just that with their default set for Excel 2013. By choosing a sans-serif font, Calibri Light, for titles, and also a sans-serif font, Calibri, for normal text. Now let's look at the 25 predefined font sets in Office 2013. I'm going to click Page Layout on the ribbon, and in the Themes group, Fonts. As well as the 25 standard font sets, you can also define your own font sets if you find that none of these are to your liking. First of all, we can see the default Office font set, consisting of Calibri Light for the headers and Calibri for the body text. This list is also a gallery, so I'm going to hover over the second font set in the list, and you can now see the default font set for Office 2007 and Office 2010. You can see that this font set used a serifed font for the titles and a sans-serifed font for the body text. If I scroll a lot further down the list, I should find an example of a more conventional font pair. And here's one that's Arial Times New Roman, that's a sans-serifed font for the title, and Times New Roman for the body text, that's a serifed font. This was actually the default font set for Office 2003 and earlier versions. So now that you understand font sets, let's move on to color sets. Color sets are a little more involved than font sets. The 10 colors along the top row are the theme colors. The leftmost four are used for text and background colors, and the other six are accent colors. This set of colours has been selected by design professionals to work really well together. There's actually 12 theme colours, but you can only see 10 of them. The two hidden theme colours are used for hyperlinks. The standard colours are best avoided. They are colours that will remain the same no matter what theme is in use. If you use standard colours or the More Colours option, the worksheet may look odd if the theme needs to be changed in the future. Let's now look at the 21 predefined Office color sets. I'll do that by clicking Page Layout on the ribbon and in the Themes group, Colors. You can see that, at the moment, the default Office color set is in use. But if I hover over the next color set in the list, you can see the effect on the sample text in the worksheet as we look at the default colour set for Office 2007 and 2010. And if I hover over the other colour sets, you can see the effect that's having on the sample text in the worksheet. If none of the 21 built-in colour sets are suitable for your purposes, you can even define a custom colour set, and we'll be learning how to do that in a later lesson. Now let's move on to the third piece of the jigsaw puzzle, the effect sets. You'll only notice a change in theme effects if you have graphic elements on your worksheet, such as drawing shapes or chart objects. You're going to work with this type of object later in session 5, but I've added a 3D button to this sheet just so that I can demonstrate themes now. Theme effects are applied to the outline and fill of shapes. Unlike font sets and color sets, you cannot define your own custom effect sets. You're restricted to the built-in 15 Office effect sets. Let's now look at those 15 effect sets by clicking Page Layout, Themes and Effects, and here they are. I'll hover over each in turn, and you can see the effect they're having on my graphic shape. The outline and fill of the shape is changing as I hover over each of the different effects. So now that you understand font sets, color sets, and effect sets, let's see how they're combined to make a theme. I'm going to click Page Layout, Themes, and Themes to see all of the built-in Office 2013 themes. It's easy to find which font set, color set, and effect set goes with each theme because Microsoft have used the same names. So I know that the Office theme consists of the Office color set, the Office font set, and the Office effect set. Let's now apply some different themes to this sample document. So I'll click Page Layout, Themes, and Themes. Remember, when I change the theme, I'm changing the color set, the font set, and the effect set all at the same time. So I'll move from the default Office theme to the Facet theme. And you can see that the appearance of the worksheet has entirely changed. Let's hover over some of the others, and you can really see how powerful this Themes feature is. The Themes feature is also included in Word, PowerPoint, Outlook, and other Office applications. So once you've learned how to use it in Excel, you'll be able to use it in all of the other Office applications as well. Choosing the same theme for your documents, spreadsheets, presentations, and emails can give all of your communications a consistent and professional appearance. In the lessons that follow, we'll be exploring every element of themes, and you'll feel really comfortable with using them for all of your documents. And you've now completed Lesson 4.8, Understand Themes.